Hey.
Hey man.
What's up?
Nothing much. Just, at home. Excited to talk a bit. Chat, how's it
It's good to.
going?
Yeah, good to talk a bit. Talk about the things going on. Now that we
Yeah.
don't have so many tournaments.
Yeah, exactly. We're both just chilling and see how it's going.
Yeah. How are you managing to practice in this lockdown? Are you able to practice or do something or?
Yeah, I mean, I'm at home right now in California, and I'm a bit lucky because I got managed to get a robot butterfly sent it to me and got some balls as well, so I can practice a bit just with the robot in my garage. And yeah, also I'm a little lucky. My dad's got some equipment at home, a little bit workout stuff, and just trying to stay active and keep going, not stay lose the feeling or nothing. So just trying to keep the touch and keep the physical.
Yeah, it's not easy to practice at home. I can imagine the struggle. I guess you're doing everything you can to keep fit. Here in Germany, we weren't able to practice for a while, but a few weeks ago they let us practice. So now we are able to stay fit and continue to practice.
Oh, that's good, man. I bet you're pretty happy when you could start to train again and
It's a very nice feeling to. Yeah, just to touch the racket, to go to the hall every day, it feels nice. Like we know the situation in the world, but it's also nice to be able to do what we do. I mean, every
Yeah,
day.
exactly. Just do what you love. I mean, it's good you can get back to them. I'm pretty happy for you.
And do you have any plans on the next weeks, or you're just waiting to see how things go?
Yeah, I mean, I've been home a while now, so it's been tough, but I'm trying to get back to Germany as soon as possible. Hopefully get to Aachen quickly. Aachen have my new club for next season, and just looking forward to hopefully going back soon and starting to play again, and yeah, just how it was, how it is normally before,
Yeah, so you are living in Grenzau, so for a few seasons now. How long?
Yeah, it was 3 years now I've been in Grenzau. End of my third season now. And yeah, so it's gonna be a bit of a change to move to a new place, but it's been really cool 3 years.
So you're not used to being so long at home like now. Is
No,
it
new
different?
feeling for me. I think same you can say same for you when you're home. I'm not home so much, so but it's nice also because I don't spend so much time with my family and my sister and stuff. So now to be home for a while, I think we're all enjoying it most of the time. Sometimes a little tension, but
Yeah, I see.
it
Ochsenhausen just announced you a few days ago that you're joining us. So I'm
Yeah.
excited to playing with you next season. How are you feeling? You're feeling motivated and
Yeah, I'm really excited actually. I mean, obviously I know Ochsenhausen, most people know how great a club it is, and obviously you were from there and Simone and so many other really good young players and top players practiced there before. So, when I got this opportunity, I thought it was really, really exciting for me. And I mean, I hope it'd be really good to have people like you and Simone who I can learn from. So
No,
I'm excited.
yeah, I'm
I mean,
sure you'll
I've
help
really been
us.
there a while, so you know
Yeah,
how it is.
sure. Sorry?
You've been there a while in Ochsenhausen,
Yeah, I'm
you know
here
how it is.
for 6 years already. So, yeah, it's already my home. My home is not Rio
Yeah.
anymore.
Yeah.
It was just a little bit hard in the beginning to move to a very small city, but you're used to it. You lived in
Yeah.
Grenzau, which is even smaller. But I'm sure you'll adapt real fast and And I guess you practice well and improve your game in a short time.
Yeah, I hope so. I think it will be a lot of fun next season.
Yeah, hopefully we can finish this season and start next season. I think it will be hard to start the season on time, but of course we hope to be able to play as soon as possible.
Yeah, I obviously you guys are in the playoffs, right? So
Yeah.
I mean, hope for you guys can happen the playoffs and you guys can get the title. But yeah, maybe it's
Yeah.
hard this season to do it.
Yeah, we're supposed to play Düsseldorf for the semifinals. Yeah, I don't have any news, but I think they're trying to make it happen.
Right.
Of course, without spectators, and I think all the players want to play. We're already for the 2 months without any matches, so I guess
Right,
everybody wants to play, but in safety at the same time. I guess we just have to wait and see how things develop.
yeah, hopefully, I mean, for everyone, I think would enjoy to watch TT again, so, and
Yeah.
obviously you guys want to play, so I hope it can happen.
Yeah. And well, how's your usual training routine? How do you do daily?
Right now, or
No, I mean in general. When you're in your normal practice routine.
right. I mean, normally I think it's maybe a little similar to yours. I don't know, but I normally wake up, have a session in the morning from maybe 9, 9:30 to lunchtime, and it can change the timings of practice, and then normally some stuff like cool down and have lunch and rest. And then normally again in the afternoon, start training again around 3, 4 for 2, 3 hours till the evening time. And yeah, after that, just different stuff. Sometimes doing some many balls, sometimes physical training, some service, and then you know how it is, have dinner, you're tired, rest, and
Yeah, I guess it's pretty standard. Our practice routines. I guess everybody in the world is doing more or less the same kind of practice.
yeah.
Especially young players, we practice most of the times twice a day, and around 3 hours in the morning, 3 hours in the afternoon. We do also some physical work, and do you practice a lot service? Because I don't, to be honest.
My motivation is kind of coming and going with the service, you know. I would say normally before the match, the day before, I try to just practice serves a bit. Just to feel if it's a different ball or table, a little bit. My can both do the high toss serve, so just try to feel. But also, I can definitely raise the amount of time I'm serving.
Yeah, actually, first of all, I think it's boring to practice service,
A
and
little
my left shoulder gets very tired because I throw the balls
bit.
high, so it's very hard for me to practice service. But I think I could improve my service just during normal practice. So I was looking for things just during the exercises and not really doing service like when I not really taking time to do 1 hour of service or things like this.
Right, just practicing serve while you're training in the difference.
Yeah, you can
Well,
work on more than one thing at the same time.
yeah, exactly. Yeah, I can say from experience that your serve is pretty good, so
Thanks.
been working.
Yeah, thanks. Then how did you start to play? Because I met your sister in Venezuela in 2009.
Okay, I didn't know
Yeah, I remember her. She was there, and did you start playing with her and or
Yeah,
later?
I actually started playing just because of her. I used to play when I was really young, just soccer, football, I guess you'd say. And then my sister was playing table tennis with my parents, and I was really young, so I would just go and watch her practice with my parents. And she was playing, so I wanted to also. And it's really only because of her I started. So pretty grateful to her now, looking back.
Yeah. And how old were you?
It was 5 years old, actually. So I was pretty small, not really above the table, just kind of holding the racket.
Yeah, I remember you very small, but not that small.
Yeah, I've always been small, so but even smaller back then.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think first time we played was actually maybe in World Cadet Challenge.
Yeah, I think
If
so.
I'm not correct.
2012 in Puerto Rico.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Yeah, I remember.
You were playing for the Hopes team, right?
Yeah, it was the ITDF Hopes team.
Yeah.
It was pretty cool. And then you think you've reached the semis or something. I remember you reached
Yeah.
the semis, right? Yeah, and at the time I was pretty happy. I'm like 12 years old, and I got to play you, and I was like, wow, this guy is so good. Yeah, I'm still so good, but yeah, it was a cool experience.
Yeah. It's cool to remember the first time. I think that was the first time we met, or
Yeah, it's hard to remember now. Maybe, but it's been a long time now, for sure.
yeah. I remember one time when we went to practice in China. Were you there? I think you were there as well.
Maybe.
In
I've been to China so many
Guangzhou.
times. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, I think I
Do
remember
you
you like
remember
the
when?
first. When?
Yeah.
Think it was in 2013.
Okay. Yeah, it can be. Maybe
I
your
think you were
memory is.
probably with Kunal.
Ah, then yeah, probably. You remember my teammate.
Yeah.
Yeah. Then, yeah, you probably remember. Yeah. Pretty cool, I think, that we. When you see players, other guys from, since you're young, and then when you see them for such a long time, it's pretty cool stuff. Now we're teammates, so.
Yeah, especially as coming from countries where table tennis is not very popular, and
Yeah.
yeah, it's cool to see you reaching this level, getting your great results, and also, how is table tennis in the USA now? Is it growing with your results, or is it changing something?
Yeah, I think it's grown a bit. I think it started first with when I moved abroad to Europe, and then Lily Zhang is also living professionally, and now we got some more players, professional. Also, I think Nikhil Kumar and Nick Teo, my teammates, they're also training more and more professionally, and we're playing better now as a team. So, I mean, we're getting better. I know you guys are also now really a top country, especially when you reached, I think, the quarterfinals in Hampstead World Championships. I thought that was amazing also to see you guys from Brazil against the
Yeah,
best country in
it was a cool
Europe.
experience. I mean, we beat Croatia in the round of 16, 3-2.
Right.
It was a very tough match. I think the Tsuboy was down 2-0 or 2-1, 6-2, something like this, and he came back to win the match. And then we
Right.
played Germany in the quarterfinals, and Timo and Franziska didn't play.
Right, right. Was a good chance.
Yeah, we had a good chance, but unfortunately we didn't do it this time. But it's already a very good result for Brazil, I guess.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, just not when people are used to seeing countries like Brazil and USA doing well, so whenever you do well or stuff, it's really great for all of us to see, and really inspiring.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, I can say since you started playing, you've always inspired me because, you know, I kind of feel we're a little bit similar, that we're both from Pan America, and you're always making such great results, so it's always inspiring to me to keep going forward and try to follow as well, you know. So
That's
can say
very
thank
nice
you.
to hear. Yeah. And what do you think it was your best match so far, or a few of them?
I mean, I think one of my most memorable matches was with Ma Long, actually, in Budapest last year. I mean, I never growing up, I played against like Ma Long. You know, he's just someone I see on my TV, and I know a lot of people in the USA were also really excited at the time. You know, because it's not so often you get to see US players playing against the best players. And yeah, it was, I actually played really well. I think you played him 2 rounds later, so you know, I got the first set, and I was kind of close with him throughout the match. I also had a set ball in the fourth, so was pretty memorable at the time. And I think it also helped that in US, a lot of people then saw the result and were thinking like, wow, we're doing better. So I hope also it inspired some people.
Yeah, it was a great match. You played really well, I remember. But I played Malone 3 times, but all
Yeah.
the times he was in the World Championships and he was at his best. So
Right.
it was very
Maybe not
tough.
the best time to play
Yeah,
him.
when he's playing well, it's really hard to play against him. He's very strong on the short game, and he reads the
Right.
game really well. So it's really tough to play against him when he's prepared.
You're right. I mean, but now you also, I mean, you beat a lot of good players already. You beat Fenzhen Dang now in the grand finals. So how was that experience?
It was crazy. I mean, he was the world number one at the time. And I was feeling really well from already in the warming up, so I felt I could have a chance to win the match, and I started the game already dominating from the first point. I started 2-0 up, and I really thought I had a chance, and I was playing better and better. Of course, I knew with his level he was able to come back at any time, but I knew I
Right.
just had to continue to play my game, to be aggressive, to not think too much about the consequences if I win or if I lose the match. And yeah, I
Right.
was focused. I played really strong, and yeah, that's for sure my best victory so far.
Yeah, I've watched that match a couple of times. It's some crazy shots in there. You played really. I'm sure a lot of people in Brazil were also really excited when you beat Fenzhen Dang.
Actually, it was in Korea. So yeah, maybe it was at night in Brazil. I don't know if people were able to follow the match.
Right, right.
But I think when they woke up, it was a very good news for Brazilian table tennis, and they were all very happy, I guess.
Yeah, for sure.
I remember your match against Lin Yongju in the Youth Olympic Games. This was very nice, because he was not at this level now, but he was already a very good player, and to beat him for the medal was a very good result as well.
Yeah, I think that was definitely the best win so far of my career. Also, it was a big match. So, I mean, obviously now he's really amazing, just fantastic. But yeah, before the match, I knew it would be really hard because he was already playing so good at the time. But I saw he was actually, I felt he was a little nervous going in. I think also because people had a lot of expectations on him to at least get a medal. And yeah, somehow I just played amazing that match. I felt like both everything was flowing well and playing well, you know the feeling, and somehow I managed to win 9 in the 7th, but was really a crazy match, and don't know if it'll be so fun to play him again now, but Definitely a really memorable match for me, and also to get a medal in the Youth Olympics was really good for USA table tennis.
Yeah, sure. And it just made me remember a fun fact. Actually, next year we'll have on the team the guy who won the bronze medal in the Youth Olympic Games 2010, 14, and 18, because
Ah, right,
Simon won the
Simona.
bronze medal in Singapore. Me
Right,
in
right.
Nanjing
Oh, that's
2016,
pretty
and he's
cool.
2000. Yeah, that's funny.
Yeah, so we got three bronze medals on the team.
Yeah.
Hopefully we get more than the bronze though next season.
Yeah. I think so. I think the team's really good. Yeah, I guess we'll have to fight. There are many good teams in the Bundesliga now.
Yeah.
Yeah, so
Yeah, for sure. I mean, it was my first season out playing the league, and it was really a really cool experience for me. I mean, every weekend playing such good players. I mean, you're obviously played many years, but I thought it was really, really exciting for me. I hope next season we can do well together.
yeah, I think we, yeah, players can improve a lot by playing regularly with top players in the Bundesliga, and it's a very good experience for all the players. You have to improve your consistency. It pushes you to always play well, and I guess everyone can improve from that.
Yeah.
Yeah. Did you do any other sports growing up, or you told me you played soccer?
Yeah, I played some other sports. Played a little bit of soccer growing up, and always in school. I mean, I'd play basketball with my friends. I mean, in US, basketball is the biggest deal. I mean, I love NBA as well. Wasn't very good on it, to be honest, in the sports. but I definitely love playing. I mean, but then once started playing more and more table tennis and got more and more busy, and then just started to focus on TT and nothing else. Yeah, I still love to watch NBA and follow the stuff. And US, obviously, everyone loves it. So, and I've seen a few clips from you also playing basketball and among other things, so I know you're pretty good. So
Yeah,
maybe I can.
I love to play other sports. As soon as I go back to Brazil, I go to the streets to play some basketball. Yeah, I've played also volleyball, and I did
Yeah.
long jump as well.
Wow.
But yeah, every time I have free time, Vitor Ishii is saying that you'll join our fantasy NBA league next year.
Yeah. Oh, nice. I love the
Yeah, that's a shame because I was leading the league. He was second,
NBA,
but now I'm missing the game and setting my
Yeah.
every day. I'm missing the
Missing
to
the
watch
action.
NBA games. Yeah, missing the
Yeah.
action.
Yeah, I can imagine. You did, what would you think your favorite sport if you had to not play, if you weren't playing table tennis? Because I
Sorry?
know what your favorite sport would be if you weren't playing table tennis. Because I know you're good in a lot of sports, so.
It's very hard to choose. I played volleyball for a club, so I was playing in the some tournaments. Basketball, I never really practiced. I just fell in love with the sport later. But I like both of them. I think these are my two favorite sports other than table tennis.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, it's hard. Table tennis is always indoors, so it's always nice. We're always practicing, so it's good to see other sports sometimes and watch other things.
Yeah, I think you can improve a lot by doing other things as well. You improve your coordination. You can get many different things, not only by playing table tennis, but also doing different activities.
Yeah,
I'm sure.
exactly.
And one more specific question: What do you think is the most important quality on a top player, in a top table tennis player?
It's a good question. I mean, I think a lot of top players, they have different strengths depending on their style. I mean, everyone has their own specific style. But I think always top players, they have a good mental strength. I mean, now this was one of my first years coming out of the junior age group, and you can really see, you know, when I'm playing the Bundesliga and top senior players, how much with tactics and calmness and focus they play with. I mean, I've definitely learned a lot now how to stay focused, and for me, I think that's one thing that top players are really, really good at. I know you also are really calm in the match, so.
Yeah, I think it's definitely one of the most important things. Probably some players prioritize some things, some players prioritize other things, but I think the mental part must always be there. We just got a hello from Timo. Hello, fellow teammates.
Hey man, he's an ox also now, right? With you, right? So
Yeah, we are practicing together. Yeah.
nice.
Shall we move to the statements, to the little trivia quiz?
Yeah, I think.
Yeah. So
I
guys,
did see that.
some statements. Some of them are true, some are false, and the other guy will have to guess if it's true or false. So you want to start?
Yeah, I can start. Let me just see what they put down.
Yeah.
Maybe better you start, I think, and then I'll.
Okay. So the first one, I was a pen holder when I started to play.
I mean, I've never seen you playing pen hold actually, so I can't tell how good you are. But I mean, I've seen you play since we were cadets, so I'm gonna go with false.
Correct, that's false.
False, yeah. Nice, so I got one.
Yes, 1.3. So do you have them there, or should I do all of mine first?
Yeah, better do all of yours first, and then
Okay. My first appearance at a World Championships was in 2013. I mean, at a seniors World Championships.
right. Hard question because I wasn't playing the World Championships back then, but I know in 2013 you're already a really one of the best, maybe the best player in Brazil. So I'm going to say also false. Maybe
Yeah, it was 2012, the first time I
2012.
played in the team World Championships. Yeah, two
Yeah.
points for
Nice. Good
you.
stuff.
So the next one, I know the capital city of all the countries in the world.
Actually, you know, man, I saw one guy send me a clip actually of you when you're doing physical training and you were saying the capitals while you were biking and you were nailing them. But you know, I've said two false already. I'm gonna say true.
That's true.
True, nice.
So, seems like you know me pretty well.
I'm doing pretty well so far, but let's not jinx it.
So now I often listen to the final countdown to concentrate before matches.
Really good song. But I'm just going to say false.
No, that's true.
Ah.
Yeah.
Good time, good time.
Yeah, not every time, but many times I listen to this song before the matches.
Yeah. Good song, so it's
Yeah.
working.
Yeah. Next one. I speak seven languages.
Oof. Well, I know just from the top of my head, you speak German. You speak French. I know you have a French coach. Okay, English, so that's three. Portuguese, Spanish, that's five. I know my t old teammate, my buddy Carlo, said he speaks Italian sometimes with you. So that's six now. And I'm just gonna guess you know one more, so I'll say it, true.
No, that's false. You got all of them.
I got all of them, six.
Yeah, I mean, Italian, I can speak a little bit. I always talk to Carlo in Italian, but because
Right.
it's very similar to Portuguese, Spanish, and French, which I speak. So I just started to talk to him in Italian, and I was just guessing some words, and I can communicate with him.
Really?
So I'd say 5.5.
Five and a half. Okay, I don't think many people would get that.
Next one.
So I'm two and two now.
Yeah, 2-2. No. You're 3-2.
Oh, nice, right. Three and two. So I'm still positive.
Yeah, that's good. So I entered in the top 10 for the first time in 2018.
Oof. I know in 2018 you had some really big results. I think you also beat Fendon, right, in 2018.
Yeah.
So I'm gonna say true.
It's true. Yeah.
True, huh? Nice. Good feeling, I'm sure,
4-6.
when you got a top 10, your name in there.
Yeah. I think it was on July. It was in July when I entered for the first time. And then I was 1 month at 11. And then I came back and stayed in the top 10 since till today.
Oh, nice. Yeah, I'm sure that's a good feeling
Yeah,
when you see
you'll
the
get
name
there soon
in
enough.
there. Hopefully.
So the next one, I have never tasted any alcoholic drink.
Oof. I know actually I've heard that you don't drink alcohol. So, but to never taste, hard to imagine. I'm gonna say actually false.
It's true.
It's true.
Yeah.
Really? Wow.
Yeah, I think not many people have never tasted any alcoholic drink, so yeah.
Or even by accident, or like,
Well,
you
not that I know of, so
know. Fair enough.
yeah. So
Wow.
4-3.
4 and 3. Okay. It's not strong start, kind of ended now, so.
It's good, it's good. So the last one is I have an older sister.
This one, I mean, I've seen your family many times in the Pan Am. I know you know my family too, and I know you have a younger sister. For sure, I think false, because I've actually seen you post before, and
Yeah, that's false.
before.
So good.
Five
Five
and three.
correct answers and 3 wrong.
Right, okay, score then, I think.
Yeah, it's good. It's good enough. Maybe next year you'll be able to get all of them right.
Yeah, I think so. By eight, I think. Think I'm doing pretty good then. We'll be happening by next season.
Yeah, sure. Not sure I'll be able to beat your score.
Yeah, we'll see now what my score is. Maybe also by next season you got some more languages, so It's gonna change to six from 5.5.
Hopefully.
I got my statements now, actually, if you're ready.
Let's go.
My first one is my favorite player is Chuang Chi-Yuan.
That's a hard one. I'll say true.
Yeah, it is true. Yeah, he's always been my favorite player. I really like his style.
Yeah,
I
he.
think,
Yeah,
yeah,
I
I think
love the
he's a
way he
little
plays.
similar
Very
because,
smooth.
yeah, exactly.
Yeah, he's
So you
very fast. He doesn't have so much power, but he's so fast and he compensates in other areas.
yeah,
I love to
exactly.
see him.
That's why I really like to see him play. I think I'm not like so powerful or so strong, but when I see Chuang, how he plays, I really enjoy watching him. So, always been my favorite player.
Okay, cool.
So, the second one is I first started training abroad in Halmstad, Sweden in August 2014.
I think you started earlier. I'll say false.
False. It is false, but actually started later.
Later.
You got it false. You still got it.
That final answer was good.
Final answer was good. Yeah, I started in 2015. I moved with my sister, so.
Okay.
But you got it anyway. So now you're two. Next one I'd say is, I think this is a pretty easy one for you, but it's written down, so I am vegetarian.
That's absolutely true.
Yeah, I think I'm pretty sure you would have got that one right. And you're also vegetarian, so.
We've talked a lot about vegetarianism, and so obviously we know we are both vegetarian.
Yeah. So 3 for 3 so far. Better start now than me. My next one, I can speak Hindi and English.
I'll say true.
False, actually. Don't speak Hindi, just English.
Or do you know a few things?
I can understand actually a very little amount, but I'm not exactly good at learning languages. Actually, my number of languages is one, so.
Okay, so you'll have to learn German next season with us.
Yeah, I mean, actually, everyone in the US are like my coaches and parents. They know you know German. So because of you, now I got to learn also. Well, it's good for me to learn, but they always say, "Ah, Ugo knows German, so you got to learn." So.
Your coach tells me every time you should I should teach you or you or that you should learn German.
Yeah, he's always killing me for it. So it would have been better if you didn't know, actually. But okay, it's I need to learn. So, one now, I think. This next one, I've reached the knockout stages of the last two men's World Cups.
So the last one, obviously, we played.
Last one, yeah.
And the other one, I think you lost to Simon and you beat Aruna. So it's
Yeah.
true.
Yeah, it's true. It's true. Damn, I think these statements are gonna, they're too easy for you. next one is my former coach, Li Zhenxi, taught me the high top serve.
Which serve?
The my high toss serve.
I'll say also true.
It's also true.
That was a complete guess.
Yeah, he's not many people know him, but he was my one of my first coaches, and he used to do the high top serve. He was also world champion for China before, so
Okay.
that's how I learned it also. So you're at one wrong so far,
Yeah.
huh? Yeah, I think you're gonna beat my score. I think you already did,
I
but
think my statements were a little bit harder.
yeah. The last one is I'm the youngest table tennis athlete to represent USA at the Olympics. And second last one.
So I think that is false.
It's actually true.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I wasn't sure actually until I saw it. It was true, so, but it's true.
Okay, cool. Nice.
And last one is I won two medals at the 2019 Pan American Games in Lima.
You want two? That's for sure. I'm just checking if you want three. No, I think you got two medals.
Actually false. I got three.
Oh.
Yeah. The mixed doubles, I
Mixed
don't
up,
think
yeah. I thought
you
you lost mixed.
considered.
Okay.
Yeah. The mixed doubles. So think
We
you
got
got
the same
same
result.
score.
Good.
Matt, I came back in the end though with the hard questions.
Yeah, I think you changed the questions on the list.
Yeah.
Shall we check for some questions on the comments? And
Yeah.
then
Sure.
we're good to go. If you see something. There are many people just saying hi, I guess.
Yeah, a lot of not so many questions I can see, I
Yeah.
think. But
Danny Akbari asked me my record in solving the Rubik's Cube. So my record is 6 seconds, 6.0 seconds.
6.0 seconds. Wow. And what would
Yeah.
you say is like your average time?
My average is like 9.5.
Oh, really? So you were like 3 seconds ahead.
Sorry?
3 seconds faster than the
Yeah.
normal.
Yeah,
Ooh.
yeah.
What's the highest number of biggest Rubik's Cube you've solved? Like instead of 3 times 3, the cube.
I solved a few times the 13 by 13.
Really?
Yeah, I actually have a video on it. I posted a video on
I think I saw it, yeah. How long did it take you?
it took me 1 hour and 40 minutes and some sore muscles on the
Well, that's crazy that you did that. I have
Yeah, that's
never
just
even done one side on a Rubik's
no, that's
cube,
just a hobby which I enjoy doing. It's yeah, I think it's relaxing for me, I guess.
yeah, I mean it's good, pretty cool. I mean, I always see the everyone knows the Rubik's cube, so. You see any more questions?
Let me check.
I saw one from also from Danny Akbar. Do you think the two-handed backhand will be a standard shot in table tennis?
That's a very good question. I actually do think so. Every time now I go to some countries or I go to practice, people, especially kids, look at me and then and talk about the two-handed backhand, and I see more and more kids trying to do it, and I think soon some players will be doing much better than me. I mean, I don't think it's gonna be a the standard backhand won't be the two-handed backhand, but I think more players will start to use it.
Yeah, I think so also. I mean, I already see now some players always trying to practice it, and
Yes, Simon already got it.
yeah, among
He
that as well.
does it many times during the matches, and many people criticize me by because I tried and they say I should just use one hand, but it's just I just use the two-handed backhand when the ball is very far to the backhand, and it gives me more control, and it helps me to keep being aggressive. Because it's very hard to reach the ball and have control this way. So just with the other hand to stabilize the wrist.
And you were just trying it in training one time and thought it was better. Well, I thought you realized it gave you more control.
Yeah, I think I just did it for fun. But then I realized it could be helpful in certain situations. And I started to try it in practice and then in matches.
Nice. Yeah, I mean, now everyone knows it.
Yeah. Eric Sacaval asked if you have any other hidden talent.
I don't think so. Maybe I do, but then it's probably still hidden to me
But
too.
it's hidden.
No. I think just table tennis. That's what I do. So,
That's enough. That's what you need to be good at.
maybe in the future, some other hidden.
Maybe I'll teach you how to solve the Rubik's Cube next year.
Yeah, maybe I'll get the 14x14 out by next season. Well, maybe the fantasy league also. I think can be quite a talented at that. So.
Actually, if you can solve a 4x4 and a 5x5, it's not that much harder to solve the 13x13 or any number. It's just longer and more tiring.
The time. All right. I gotta learn one side first, man. So baby
Yeah.
steps.
So I guess we have to. Yeah, it's already late here in Germany. They told us to not take much more than 45 minutes. So I guess we
Yeah.
should, yeah, finish it now. But it was very nice talking to you. Thanks for this cool, nice time, and hopefully we'll do one more in the future.
Yeah, man, it was a great talk. Looking forward to see you soon in Ox. And thanks for the time, man.
Yeah, thank you, and I'm eager to see you here in Knox.
Yeah, see you, man. All right, I'm gonna end this.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.